morning, Eisenhower. Live from Studio 317, I'm your host, Anthony, along with...
Brady. Today is October 17th, Day B.
Today in history. October 17, 1888, Thomas Edison files a patent for the optical phonographic, the first movie.
Please rise for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You may be seated.
And now for today's advisory announcement with Ms. Dobson.
Good morning, Eisenhower. Just here to remind you that tomorrow's an advisory day. We're going to have an assembly in the morning, which I hope you enjoy. We'll be talking about the assembly, and then we'll be decorating doors for Red Ribbon. And we'll be giving a prize probably in the beginning of November for the best advisory door. And now, morning announcements.
Thank you. Good morning. I'm Mac, along with
Wes.
What does today's weather look like?
Today, a mix of clouds and sun. A stray of shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 79. Tonight, mostly clear, low 61. Tomorrow, mainly sunny. Record high temperatures expected. High 83. Now here's Mac with today's announcements.
Thank you, Wes. The Animal Welfare Club Halloween Pet Photo Contest is now open to all students and staff at EMS. Ask your homeroom teacher for a flyer or visit the Animal Welfare Club page on the Eisenhower website for more information. We can't wait to see your pets dressed up for Halloween. We're also holding an animal shelter supply drive now through December 13th. See the flyer for a list of supplies. Drop-off boxes will be in the main entrance hallway in room 503. See Ms. Engel or Ms. Coppola with any questions. Pollyanna rehearsal is canceled for this afternoon. Please make plans accordingly. Attention TREPS members. Please check the Google Classroom page before Wednesday for important announcements about this week's meeting. Also, remember to come to the meeting this week on the day that you signed up for. Can't wait to see you there. The Debate Club will be holding its first debate of the season this Wednesday, October 19th, right after school in room 506. The topic is marijuana legalization and features Jason in 8A and James in 8A debating Sarah in 7K and Jamie in 7C. All members are expected to attend as judges, but spectators are also encouraged and welcome. After that throwdown, other members will sign up for their debates. See Mr. W for details. The yearbook committee will start Wednesday, October 19th. If you are an eighth grader interested in helping to design and create this year's yearbook, please stop by the Media Center Lab after school from 3 to 4. If you aren't able to attend, please see either Ms. Salmon or Ms. Burns for more information. Here's Wes with the rest of today's announcements.
Thank you, Mac. The EMS girls soccer team won their sixth game on Friday against Riverville. The score was 4-0. Goals were scored by Sophia, Ariel, Mia, and Izzy. Lauren played amazing game in goal and prevented many possible goals. Our next game is Tuesday at Cresco. Girls, don't forget it's picture day. The boys soccer team lost their game versus Riverville on Friday with a score of 5-3. Griffin had two goals and Benji scored one. The boys take on Cresco tomorrow at home. Come out and support the team. The student council cookie order forms are due this Tuesday, October 18th, at the meeting after school. Students must hand in all the money with their order forms. If you can't make the meeting, please give your order forms to Ms. Fury in room 305. Halloween is coming, so it is time to ghost
Boom.
A friend. React Club members will be selling ghosts in the cafeteria for $1 every day between now and Friday, October 28th. Bring your dollars so your friends can enjoy a treat on Halloween. All profits will go to help victims of Hurricane Matthew in Haiti. Attention 7th and 8th grade boys interested in trying out for the Eisenhower basketball team. There'll be a brief meeting at 3 in room 315 on Tuesday, October 18th. If you can't make the meeting but are still interested in trying out, please let Mr. Finale know. Is Eisenhower celebrating any birthdays today?
Eisenhower wishes a very happy birthday to Benjamin in 6F, Carmen in 6D. What's for lunch today?
Today's lunch is cheese ravioli tomato basil sauce, and whole grain garlic bread. What's tomorrow's lunch?
Tomorrow's lunch is taco crunchers with turkey taco meat. What's in the headlines?
State lawmakers in New Jersey will be holding hearings focused on investigating the problems with New Jersey Transit. And now for today's feature with Sean and Reed.
Thanks, Mac and Wes.
Hey, Reed, did you hear about the social studies teachers changing grades?
Yeah, I had Mr. Oldteffel last year, and I have him this year, too.
Wow, let's go watch his feature on the social studies teachers change.
Eisenhower, so this year some teachers have been switching into a new grade. Ms. Mulgey has gone from 6th to 7th, Mr. Donald has gone from 8th to 6th, and Mr. Holsaffel has gone from 7th to 8th. Let's see how they feel about these changes. Mr. Donald, how do you feel about working with these new teachers?
Well, I'm very excited to work with new people. I've been here for 16 years, and it's nice to have a new, you know, change of pace. As much as I love my old colleagues, getting to know new people is great.
And how do you feel about teaching the new curriculum?
Well, again, taught the old one a long time, so the new one is definitely a learning curve, definitely tough for me to move from American history to world civilizations, ancient civilizations. I'm loving the sixth grade kids. It's a nice change there, too. So I'd say I like it. I'm working really hard.
Thank you.
Well, Mr. Holtzov, how do you feel about working with these new teachers?
Well, I'm very excited to work with my new colleagues. They've been colleagues of mine for years, but I never worked directly with them. So I'm really excited to work with the eighth grade teachers. And as many of you know, Mrs. Holtzaffel is an eighth grade teacher, so it's nice to be able to see her more often.
And how do you feel about teaching a new curriculum?
Well, the new curriculum is pretty terrific. This year being a presidential year, there's a lot to talk about, and eighth grade civics is, I think, is going to be something that kids are going to find very interesting, and we've already had some great discussions, so I'm really looking forward to it.
Ms. Mulgey, how do you feel about working with these new teachers?
Oh, they're amazing. They're such talented people up here, and everybody's really nice. I'm really excited for this year.
Awesome. How do you feel about teaching this brand new curriculum?
Well, you know how much I love current events and global events and all of these good things. So this is a curriculum that I really am really excited to teach.
So how do you feel about Ms. Mulgey switching to the new team?
I like it. I think she'll help me learn a lot about social studies.
As you can see, these three new teachers are looking forward to a new school year and a new grade.
Now back to our host and Brady.
Thanks, Sean and Reed.
And now for the joke of the day.
What is 1 foot long and slippery?
I don't know, what?
A slipper.
Thanks for watching, Eisenhower. Have a monkey Monday.